Kled would be one option. Does eventually start winning trades against the Shen, can have a lot of presence. So Vitality, you would be excused. One of, items we got to look at here as well as Joko's coming down to the bottom. His steal back, he's back in lane.
Vander gets the two-man play. Joko's looking for Samix, sinks the fangs in. Vitality trading damage back and forth. It's steal back with the kill. Cocoon catches Hillisang.
Making sure they can keep on top of it, but Vander might be spotted.
Oh, flash from Hillisang. Remember, Vander, he got caught earlier. Death sentence is not going to be enough. And unfortunately for Vander, he goes down. The Unicorn's on the board. This is Cabochard. He's sitting in the Tiamat into Kim's Razor. It's stunned onto Nuketak. He's going to decide to go forward. Unleashed power from Exa. Wow! Thunderlords and Dark Sphere takes him down. Nuketak didn't even use the ulti. Now Vander's in trouble. The box and flash are available. Neither are used. Unicorns get two, and they get the tower as well.
He couldn't use it because it was... And this is where they can start to really pressure towers.
Oh, look at that! Joko, goodbye!
I was not a revenge game for them, but an interesting story nonetheless is Cabochard is going to get stunned up. Nuketak may not be able to react in time.
That means retreat! But Cabochard can't retreat! He gets blown up, the man on your
sweeping statement.
But I will have tempered expectations. Because of course Vander's going to catch out Xerxes. Xerxes with that frozen heart, very tanky right now. Vitality still unable to find a kill, and Samix is untouched! Vander goes down, Chrono Break simply not enough damage. Samix with the red buff and the ace in the hole not even needed. That's a double carry. Exile takes down Steelback with just the combos. Force of Will once more. It's Scatter the Weep out and Joko's down. Exile with a double kill delayed ace on Vitality.
He's starting off Summer as he means to go on. He had some of the highest kills himself. He's perhaps the more vulnerable one, as they say, that Samix gets jumped on.
Exactly, look at the damage, but there's no support for Nuketak. Exile is dominating.
He's playing out all of these team fights.
The base has been broken open. Vizachachi's bringing the conga line up in bottom lane. Rest of Unicorns of Love gonna take down the inhibitor to some golf claps here in Berlin.
And this looks clinical.
Just an easy move over. This is just great, you know. It is beautiful to see a team win a hit, so easily close it out. Vander's gonna get popped down. Unleash power, not enough to get that. Xerxes gets the kill. Now Xerxes running for his life as he's being chunked down by Steelback. Cocoon connects from Joko, but not a lot of damage. Exile is godlike. That's his seventh of the game. Continues to move forward. Steelback forced to flash. Inhibitor number two is the target. Parallel Convergence could cut off the retreat path. The Nuketak can't follow it in. The taunt connects and Nuketak's down.
Again, Unicorns with another clean skirmish. Only one death in the entire game. Vitality came with good strategy in the early game. Good basis on a 1-3-1, but they didn't quite execute, and Unicorns punished them very hard.
13 kills for the team. 11 of them have been involved with Exile. It's a stunner to Steelback, and the Nexus is destroyed. Unicorns pick up a couple extra kills under Joko. Samix on a killing spree. They're not done yet. Exile is legendary. 9 kills, and Unicorns outclass Vitality in game one of Summer. For what it's worth, Exile did not get the 10th kill. There are bonus points.
Sure as hell will make his presence known at ending fights, because he's unkillable in the grand entrance as kind of crashes to the ground.
Now Stress with the last
game, number one of the series, looking to do this again, going underneath the tower, body slam, end of the line.
Graphics team, I love you. Team first blood participation for Joko.
It's in LeBlanc, and instantly the response comes from the exhaust. No exhaust this time.
Oh, Exile's got so much damage. Shatter Orb gets the kill. Unicorns on the board.
Unicorns maintain
charge. Remember, it's one of my favorite spell names. I like
he
to yell.
One.
Stretching strike, minion, death sentence. Hilly sends his regards.
Hilly's going to make his way up. They just spotted going down.
All right, do not think it's worth engaging 1v5. Hellasang says, nope, you are quite wrong. Catches Vander with a death sentence, shield of Durant. Flashing
game, Zersei!
Here comes Zersei! Shockwave catches on the back end. Zersei's looking for a target. Let's bounce, still on cooldown. Does it matter? Exile's got the kill. Samix gets another. The play for days from Hellasang. A heroic entrance to close the door on Vitality. That's the third of the fight before Hellasang goes down. Cabo shot. Sends his regards with the explosive cast before he's forced to burp and run away. Gets caught by the stretching strike and steal back, running low on mana. His Essence Reaver not keeping him topped up.
Exile's
Another
back.
Taunt comes down. Exile's looking for the kill. Steelback continues to chase forward, and Unicorns, 1-for-3 fights.
One for three. It looked like it should have been more from the Unicorns, but until Exile was back in the fight, there was no real way of them dealing out enough damage. They have to be careful of a counter engage here. Pings in the top lane from Cavoshard.
They don't know he's there, and Exile escapes.
But here comes Cavoshard. This is the real danger.
Right, Xerxes going to be forced to jump away. No flash for Vizachachi. Shield of Durand will buy a few seconds of time as a Justice Punch catches the Tom Kench in the gut. Vizachachi goes down, and Vitality.
Unicorns are fighting Vitality.
We've already jumped back out. The Devourer, not enough to save Nuke Dax. Like, Exile's in trouble. He's going to need the distortion soon. Flash has already been used. Distorts forward, can distort backwards by a few extra seconds. Decides not to. He manages to escape. Xerxes, Samix, Hellasang shut down Joko, and Exile is still alive. Death Sentence finds out Cabochard. The Unicorns have phenomenal team fights. Joko's able to take down the tower thanks to the help of the Rift Herald, but it's Vizachachi killing, cleaning up, shutting down Vitality for the ace.
Vitality with the Rift Herald. I love that they threw whatever they could at the Unicorns to try and make that Rift Herald play work, but in the end, Unicorns teamfighting way too strong, and again the Unicorns coming out significantly further ahead.
Just a really good mid game from UOL.
Exile and Samix, they've killed us because they have so much room. Not anymore. Exile's dead.
All right, didn't quite see how that one set up. I don't know if Exile's trying to auto-attack or stretching strike onto it. Now Kiss is what he yells. Xerxes waiting to wind up on the let's bounce. Vander forced to run for his life. Hilly comes over the wall with the flash. Where's the death sentence?
Let's bounce,
baby! Samix gets another onto Nuke Duck. Taunt up in the back end. And Vizachachi's not done yet. Xerxes sent
look to have some sense of fight in the early game, and maybe against a different team, they'd be able to carry the lead through. But Unicorn's team fighting is immaculate still to everybody else. Everybody else has been going Abyssal into more tank. You get yourself a Stone Plate in there. No Iceborne Gauntlet wants to be able to duel down. Unicorns are going to look for two kills.
Look at that. The Shockwave catches two, but Exile gets the kill. Ace in the hole will shut down Cabochard. And Samix is dominating 6-0.
This game looks out of reach for them at this point, because Unicorns of Love, they have team fought so cleanly with this composition that again is built for team fighting. And with the adjustments to tanks in the mid-season, so many of these picks actually benefit a team like the Unicorns, who are comfortable at fighting, comfortable at giving maybe early leads up, but coming back into the game when it suits them. And it's a very, very long summer split until Worlds, but if this is how the Unicorns are going to start it out, I'm excited to see how far they can go.
Indeed. Xerxes was channeling up the Elastic Slingshot, decided not to jump in. Exile's going to get out of range of the barrel roll, because in the middle lane, Unicorns are going to knock over this third inhibitor.
Vander just used his ult into the top lane and has to recall out, because Vitality can't find any exchanges that can go their favor. And Unicorn's second inhib now is down. Third inhib, excuse me, the bot lane was already taken. Unicorn's gonna look to close this with one more fight.
Yeah, they are. Stretching strike catches on Cabochard. He tries to flash away, was pulled backwards. Shockwave catches down into Exile, and he's shut down by the collateral damage. It's Samix that cleans up Nuke Duck on the back end. Now visit Chachi with those stacks on his Soul Stealer, looking at finishing up. There's three inhibitors down, and all for the style points now. Unicorns of Love already taken one of those Nexus turrets down. Let's see, Cabo, no ultimate to speak of. Xayah's doing the best to defend. Xerxes jumps in. Let's bounce is available. Goes flat. Brings back Steelback and Vander. Gets knocked up by the heroic entrance. Xerxes re-engages once more. Gets yet another kill. Vander killed off by Hellasang. The super minions are pouring into the base stress. And Unicorns of Love
They're just looking fantastic to start open the summer splits. Not done yet. Another one for Visichachi. 14 stacks on the Magi's and Unicorns 2-0 Vitality.